Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome to Whines After Whines. This is your girl, Janae.
And this is Nadja.
And if you're ready to unwind,
let's get into it.
Let's go.
Welcome back to Whines After Whines, everybody. I am your host, Nadja.
And this is Janae.
We are back with a good topic.
Another episode. This is episode number 2. Yes. And if you're coming back to listen to us again, thank you.
Many thanks
to you. You are the real MVP.
Yeah, that was exactly what I was about to say. I was about to say, because you're the MVP.
Basically.
Did I say it right?
Yeah. Do you know for a long time I didn't know what the GOAT meant? Like, when people be like, the GOAT? I never knew what the GOAT meant for a while.
I learned around last year-ish. Maybe not. Okay. Mm. Anyway.
Like, I didn't know it meant the greatest of all time.
Yeah.
Who am I? Lost Janae. And confused. Basically. So today we're talking about intimacy.
Intimacy. Sex.
Let's talk about sex, baby.
Hey.
I wish I knew how to sing. God didn't give me that talent because he know I'll be out here annoying AF.
Same here.
I would be like, oh yeah, hey.
I have a song for everything.
Oh.
Literally.
That's
washing the dishes.
What's your song for washing
dishes? Listen, I'm not going to project my voice in these people's ears right now. They don't need to hear me.
Girl, let me sip a little bit of this wine.
Girl, you better sip.
Ooh. Okay, so a little ASMR. Do you listen to ASMR?
I mean, you know, I listen to a few.
That's disgusting. But okay, that has nothing to do with what we're about to talk about, because right now we're talking about intimacy.
Sex.
And basically, we wanted to touch on this because it's such a hot topic out here in these streets. It's a hot topic for single women, for married women, for women who aren't really women, and for everything.
Pretty much.
Yes. You know what I mean by that? I don't know. It just kind of it just came out. So what are some intimacy issues that people might have been or could be experiencing?
So besides sex. there are many intimacy. I mean, you have like an emotional connection or I don't know, like
just
emotional connection.
Vulnerability.
Exactly.
From my point of view, intimacy is a lot more than just sex, as Nadja would say. It's a lot more than that. I feel like for women, it's a lot more than that. Now, you men, on the other hand,
it might be a little, but some women, on the other hand, too.
This is also true.
No type of emotional connection to a person, period. So for us, you and I, it is an emotional connection, especially being that we're married. And that's
the
only
person. Yeah, but let's be honest. Is every sexual encounter with your husband an emotional sexual encounter?
Emotional sexual encounter. Besides the fact when he want a quickie?
That's what I'm saying.
Okay, because I was about to be like...
It's like some moments aren't
as
intimate or as like, ooh, like, yes, yeah.
I love you.
Like, where you're gazing into his eyes and the moon is lit just right and it's peeking through your blinds. And it's setting on your body and then, you know, it's not like that. And it's raining outside, you know? You got your
music. She got the perfect sex.
You got Lou Ross playing in the background. Is Lou Ross too old?
Just a wee bit.
Yeah.
Jodeci.
Oh, okay. But yeah, so basically we kind of just want to talk about the difference between being intimate with, like, from a male's point of view. And I can speak from a male's point of view because I talk to one every day. Mm-hmm. And then being intimate from a woman's point of view. And hopefully we can help some of y'all out there with y'all intimacy issues because it's hard out here.
Sure is.
Especially when you add two toddlers to the mix.
That's a part of this too. When you add those toddlers to the mix.
So, let's start with the kids. When you're trying to be intimate but you got kids.
Bruh, like...
How's that for you, Najee Pataji?
You know, it's it can get tough even at night. Because, like, a lot of times at night, not all the time, because my kids do sleep in their rooms, but they will come in our room.
Yeah.
Around, I mean,
the wee hours of 1 and 2 a.m.
Yeah, I'm about to try to tell the time, so we be trying to do it. But yeah, they will come in our room in the middle of the night. I mean, a lot of times we do just put them back in their beds or whatever. But, and then sometimes we just let them sleep because we don't even want to get up.
Yeah.
But when it comes to being intimate, it gets hard around that time, even when they starting to knock on the door or doing stuff like that. Or, I mean, sometimes you just got to get one in while they're downstairs playing in the closet.
Yes. I mean, do you know the number of times?
I mean, we're married. Judge us not, okay?
Right. We could be out here like that.
We can't be out here like that in the closet. In the
wherever you got to get it in at, sis. I mean, no right. judgment. But I think it's important. So for women who are having a hard time with that, because I know we were joking, but it is a serious issue sometimes, especially if you're a stay-at-home mom. I can't imagine being at home with your kids all day, and especially if you homeschool your kids or something like that.
Yeah.
And you're at home 10 hours with your kids, and your husband come home trying to poke you, and you like...
Hold on, the kid's still here.
Right, like, I just gave them dinner and a bath, and now I'm ready to, like, get myself a bath and lay down. Like, I can see how that can be an issue.
Yeah, Janae, I didn't think about that. Like,
I did.
I know I have stay-at-home friends,
mm-hmm.
but I know them as their kids are in school at a certain point. So you brought up the whole thing, stay-at-home, homeschool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That could be difficult.
You guys, if we have somebody out there who does that, please, please, please hit us up, because we want to know.
We want to know the perspective of a stay-at-home mom.
Yes, that one really sparked my interest.
Yeah.
Stay-at-home mom who also homeschools too.
Yeah. So, because my thing is, I feel like I would not just be in the mood. Like, I done dealt with these kids all day. I done yelled at these kids all day.
Yes.
And now you trying to come home and be all lovey-dovey. No, I need some time. Definitely. Give me time to breathe before I can do that. And men, recognize that from your women. Because if you know, okay, and I'll take it to working moms. If you've spent 9 hours working, mm-hmm. an hour in traffic, mm-hmm. you got to go pick up your kids, mm-hmm. and then you got to go home, make dinner, give baths, and then as soon as you hubby walk through the door, daddy's home, and it's like, you want to wham, bam, thank you, ma'am. That ain't going to work out in that moment. So... Man, you got to be mindful of the time. Your timing is everything with this. Mm-hmm. I don't think it's just us not wanting to give it
not
as much as it is that their timing just sucks.
It just sucks. And I know, speaking from that personally, not to put our business out there, but I am a mom who works. Like, yeah. I leave my house and work. I do work from home a couple days a week, but I go to work.
You fancy.
I mean, a little bit. But I drive to work, and if anybody knows I live in Atlanta, and everybody knows Atlanta's traffic, and I do not work right around the corner from my house. I work in the city, and I live in the suburbs.
Right.
That is an hour and a half commute mm-hmm. there, and on the way back it is actually longer. It is an hour and 45 to almost 2 hours.
Yeah.
Sitting in traffic, guys, and I get home. I mean, you get to the kids' daycare, because I'm not going straight home. Their kids are not at home. I have to get them from daycare, get them from a sitter house, because they go two different schools. Get them home. I have to cook dinner, get them ready for bed, let them have a little bit of playtime and homework time, and then baths in bed. And then my husband works nights, so when he gets home, like you said, he's like,
let's go.
Yeah, he's kind of, like, he has energy. I mean, granted, I don't know if... all people are like my husband, because he has energy when he's home from work. I mean, granted, he's tired, but he's up on the phone,
yeah,
talking, because his mother and his family lives 4 hours away from us, so we're not around the corner from our family. So, yeah, it's hard. So, and then he gets home and he's amped.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And I know you know, too, because
yeah.
your husband works overnight at times.
Yeah, his schedule is crazy, so... When he is ready, it's like, okay, but I'm kind of like working or I'm about to do something or whatever.
Exactly.
I mean, we don't really have, like, a, I guess, an intimacy issue at all, really, to be honest. Not trying to, like, pat myself on the back, but we've done really well with communicating. And that's a whole nother thing. I want to make sure we touch on that. Because you have to communicate.
You do.
When it comes to having sex with your partner. Regardless of marriage.
Yeah. Well, kind of different.
What do you mean?
For like a single person who, they have two different homes.
Yeah.
So they know for a fact they're not going to see each other every single night. But when they get together, I mean, it's like...
Oh, you know that it's going down.
Because yeah, that's how it was for me.
It's unspoken. That's an unspoken rule.
Yeah. I yeah, guess you can say,
that's
like,
more of an unspoken rule.
It's like,
rule.
You see me, like, love. Right. You know, let's go. Right.
But when you have a penis that lives in the house with you every single day, mm-hmm. yeah, you know, it's going to be there. It's right there. So, like, when you have that, it's like, you... For women, we have to be more vocal about what we want, and we have to learn how to vocalize it without coming off so strong or so. Okay, so basically, the man is thinking, all he's thinking is sex, is getting into the end, his end result. He don't care about your feelings, your emotions, what your hair look like, whether you went and ran a bit, you had a brisk jog that day.
Oh, they definitely don't care.
He and you trying to be like, hold on, let me jump in the shower real quick. He don't care about that. He just, you know, it's the end goal in mind.
Yep.
Women, we have a lot of thoughts going on. It's like, hold on, let me go, like, you know, make sure I'm good. Mm-hmm. Let me make sure the kids is good, because if they busting this door and my legs is up, like, that's not going to be a good thing for my children to experience.
Lord, we lie every time. We lie, we can't.
Right.
I'm too scared of that one.
Like, we just have a lot of things that we're thinking about and that mm-hmm. goes on through our heads. So, men, my advice to you mm-hmm. is to take a step back and not think with that part of your body and mm-hmm. think about the things that your partner has going on.
Mm-hmm.
Because... she might got 1,000 things going on, and you just not caring or not mm-hmm. thinking about it. So just be mindful of that. And women, don't just be like, "Can't you see that I'm trying to?"
Right.
Like,
cause I have been like that before. Like, I'm tired. Okay, I just put the kids to bed. I just cooked.
And then you're moving the hand out of the way. Like,
yeah.
Uh-oh.
So yeah, Janae, you hit it on the head. Like. We also have to look at our own faults as women. Like, we just cannot blame the men.
Yeah. Especially when we know exactly how they are.
Yeah.
And you have to say, like, okay, like, listen, John. This is how I like you to touch me.
Right.
And this is how I don't like you to touch me. If you want, this is the combination to the safe. Okay? If you want to unlock this safe, this is exactly the combination that you need to do to unlock it. Some women like foreplay, and sometimes foreplay doesn't come with touching as much as it is like sending me like little cute emojis before you get home mm-hmm. or like telling me how much you love me, telling me, you know, that emotional stuff.
Yeah, you just switched over to a different
part
intimacy
of it. Yeah.
Part. No, and I'm glad you did, because that is a situation that some people do have, is emotions. Some women. And even men, they want to feel loved.
Yeah.
They want the touch. They want the, like you said, the foreplay and yeah. the cute emojis.
My husband is a physical touch type of person. I think mm-hmm. that's his love language. Mine yeah. is like words of, no, hit. My husband's is words of affirmation. Mm-hmm. And mine is whatever it is about getting things done.
I can't even remember mine. I couldn't even tell you. You had me take the quiz. And
yes,
I
encourage everybody to take it, because it's very interesting. And maybe your marriage changed. Maybe you change over time. So it's good to take it. But I am more like, oh, mine is actions. Like, if my husband, if I come home and he's vacuuming, or...
Oh, that's sexy.
If he's, like, washing the dishes.
Girl, talk
ooh,
to me.
I'm like, okay, so what? So what you want me to do?
It literally just happened to me.
So I was like,
yes.
If you do that, then that's my love language. Mm-hmm. For me, if I tell my husband, oh, you look good today, you know, rubbing on his head and all that.
I think that's similar. Yes, because now that you say that, I think we were like, they're kind of similar.
Yeah.
How my love language results were and yours are. But no, you're right. Like, if I'm coming home to dinner like I did yesterday, I am not going to lie, guys. I was so happy.
Yes.
So happy.
Girl, what he cooked?
Girl, he cooked fish, broccoli. Like, he baked some fish.
Mm-hmm.
And some broccoli and some rice. Yeah. And shrimp, too.
What?
It was so good. And
did he feed the kids?
Yeah, he went to the Mexican restaurant and got them cheese dip. He was like, don't touch my fish.
Oh, my God.
Yep.
Hilarious.
That's exactly like, we had our stuff set up in the bar and the kids was at the other table with like cheese dip.
But see, that type of stuff.
He did that, though.
I'm a sweet, simple girl.
Same.
It doesn't take a lot to please me. Mm-hmm. I don't need a helicopter. I don't need, like, my name in lights. I don't, you know how, like, the little plane go by and it got the little thing with the banner?
Yeah.
I don't need, like, all of that. Yeah. I just want you to, like, if we can do, like, if you could put the kids in the bed for me, so one less thing I have to do, you know, if you got to get them some melatonin just to ease, you know, ease it in a little bit.
I'm going
to
talk about that though.
get the kids to bed and then, you know, set up a little picnic. We got a picnic basket somewhere around here. Even if we ain't got no basket, maybe a turkey sandwich with some wine on the side and some grapes or something.
Yes, like, honey.
And talking. Then you can put a little movie up on the TV. We can sit there and just have a good time. Like, it don't have to be extravagant.
And I had to stress that to my husband, Janae. Same. Like, I literally had to, because I'm going to tell you this, from when we first got together, he was all about, let me buy. Because we had no kids, of course.
Mm-hmm.
And we dated for a long time. We were boyfriend and girlfriend for a long time before the kids came into the picture. Girl, we were together 10 years before we...
No, 10 well, years but, before you had kids?
Oh, no, before we had kids, we were together probably like 8 years. I can't even think, y'all. I will have to get this math or I'll get y'all straight on my relationship and anniversaries and stuff.
She just in it.
It was about 8 years. We were together for a while because people was like, when y'all gonna get married? When y'all have kids?
Did y'all ever have a desire to get married and have kids? Mm-hmm. When y'all were together for 8 years?
Yeah, we definitely did. At one point in time, he went through some stuff. Because he lived far. We actually had a long distance. It was 4 hours, but it was like a long distance relationship. And he lost his job because he had 2 good jobs. Like, he was making bank. And he knew how to save his money. You know, he knew how to work with his money. And we had fun. But when it came to, when he lost those jobs, just because places went out of business and other things like that, he came up here and he came up here to Atlanta. And he, I remember he used to tell me all the time, he was like, you know, I just want to make sure I get my finances straight.
Yeah.
This, and that. And he just couldn't land that right job.
Yeah.
But then when he finally landed that right job, he did. And I told him, I always told him, like, I don't care about the money.
Yeah.
I don't care about it. And it's hard to believe. And now, nowadays.
Oh, because, God. No, it's always about securing the bag.
Yeah, it's exactly right there. So it's a little hard for them to believe that because they know we see social media.
Maybe we're older millennials, so that's why we're like...
I mean, people our age is still the same. Like,
yeah, you're
right. I can't... I just think we just have hearts and we don't... And we know how to make our own money, too.
Yeah.
Not like, oh, we miss independent, we don't need no man. No, but we know how to... If stuff go down, we know how to pick up.
Right.
That's just both of us.
Yeah, 100%.
And, yeah, we just, but I told him that, but, you know, I let him do it at his own time, and that's what took a while, but, yeah, to go back on topic, I don't care about the diamond rings
and the glitz and the glamour,
Gucci and, you know, all the stuff that girls like now. I mean, okay, if you get it from me at the
age. Yeah, I mean, I'm
accepting with open arms. I love me a nice Tiffany bracelet, if you're listening, but that's, I mean, I'm not. Basing my relationship off that Tiffany bracelet
that you really want. One day, sis. But yeah, so kind of like along the same lines, I know this has been like a I don't want to say a struggle. Mm-hmm. Maybe it is a struggle. It's a struggle for both of us. We've had kids. Mm-hmm. We've gained weight.
Oh, yes. Weight. My husband don't care, and I know yours don't.
At all, but I do.
We care. We care.
Well, let's be honest. My husband has also gained weight.
Yeah. My husband's up and down.
Yeah.
He's up and down. At one point, he lost a whole lot of weight. Like, right before our wedding.
Yeah.
He lost a lot of weight, but... It don't bother me if he do. I don't want him to be out here like, hey, walk, you know.
Yeah, but see, I'm little. I'm not little as in size. I'm little as in like, I don't know, height.
Yeah.
Like I'm a petite person,
you're still
woman.
Petite, but...
So I'm not gonna give my height out here because I want to be 5'7".
Little.
Me
too. I want to be 5'7".
But if I was 5'7", the weight would be so right.
Yeah, to be stretched out. I mean, yes. I'd still be thicker.
Not really.
Okay.
but yeah, like, so being intimate while gaining weight. I mean, when I had my first child, I felt like Jace gave me, like, the perfect amount of curves. Mm-hmm. I had a little, you know, something to work with. Mm-hmm. And then Callie came, and it was like, whoop, child. This ain't, it wasn't.
But I think you snapped back after Callie. I think you, and like, you're not even fat, but I think what you did was motherhood got to you.
Yeah.
I think personally that's all what happened with both of us. Now, me personally, I've never been a small person. I'm short, but I've never been a skinny, skinny girl. I've always been thicker. And, but now this is the biggest I've ever been. And it does make me feel insecure.
Yeah, because, okay, so do you have a problem, like, if all the lights are on and you can see yourself?
It bothers me. Okay. It bothers me, but he embraces me, so.
He just makes you feel so good better. That you don't
but
even
I
think
still,
about it.
But I still, my thoughts still kind of outweigh his. Like, I'm like, yeah, no, I gotta get this weight off. I gotta get this weight off. I gotta do this, and this.
Yeah.
Like, put the cheesecake down.
And not to be too graphic, but if it's like, if it's a certain position where I can feel myself being fat, then it's
no,
like...
You ain't gotta explain, because
it's like, I'm so, like, unattractive. But meanwhile, he don't care. Like...
My husband don't give two crap.
Don't care about none of it. And then, like, I could be walking around and he'd be like, ooh. Like, that's... Mm-hmm. Andrew's very flirty. He's a very flirty, touchy-feely person.
You wouldn't think that about D, but he is.
Yeah.
Very touchy-feely.
So, like, he could just look at me and be like, you know, biting his bottom lip, mm-hmm. like, you know, come over here, and I'm like, oh my God, I'm blushing. The kids are watching. What are you doing? And it's like, he don't, but if I look at myself in the mirror, sometimes I'm like, but then, like, those times is the times that he liked me the most.
Yeah.
And I'm like, ew.
Why do you
so
like
disgusting.
Me? I'm the same way. Trust me. I totally get it.
I just want to be able to look at myself in the mirror naked and be okay with me.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's my ultimate goal. And also, another one of my goals is, you know how when you open your phone and you accidentally turn on the camera and then it shows like your...
your double chin?
My goal is a little fine. From that view. When I have reached being fine from that view on my phone.
Unexpected selfie mode.
Then, yeah, if I can look fine unexpectedly in the selfie mode, then I have conquered life.
Conquered. I agree. I can't even deny that. I agree.
That's where I'm at with that.
That's perfect. That's perfect.
What else you got about intimacy? Anything else about intimacy?
I do.
What?
I actually have a requested topic.
Okay.
When it comes to intimacy. I have a cousin who asked me to touch on this because this is an issue that I believe she is having. She is a mother of a teenager. Single mother.
Teenage boy or girl?
Teenage boy.
Okay.
I believe he is about 16, 17. Maybe. He's not 18, so it's either 16 or 17.
Is he the only one?
He's the only child.
Okay.
She's an amazing mom. She has her life together. She's good. Only thing is, she's dating.
Okay, so she's not with his dad.
Mm-mm, no, she's a single mom. She's not with his father. and she's dating. And I guess, and you know, of course, we don't know. I can't answer this question, but I am going to get an answer from her and maybe somebody else who's in this situation. But she has intimacy issues, like if she brings her guy home and like he's there. And I get what she's saying. But guys, if whoever's out there who might can answer this, we would love that. She's having, you know, I guess I can't even get the words out, but I'm guessing like it's kind of like I can't do it with my son in the other room who knows what it is. Like, he knows if I bring a guy through that door, what we probably about to do if I go in my room and close the door.
Is her son sexually active?
You know, I don't know. He all I gotta say is he better not be.
At 16?
I mean
17? I mean, I wasn't. I was a saint out here.
Yeah, I was too, definitely. I was definitely not sexually active at 16, but
boys are, yeah.
He's a boy, and he's a handsome boy.
Is there not, like, a way, like, I mean, I guess I can't say, like, oh, go to his house because
I'm not sure what his situation is.
Right. I'm putting myself in her shoes. Mm-hmm. And my son, it will be important for me to have my son be real cool with the guy that I'm dating, mm-hmm. to make it a little less awkward if he's like a serious person that you're dating, like a.
But see, I could think be a father figure. I think he is cool. I think they are pretty cool, but I think it's still because I feel her in the back of my mind. I'm like, yeah, I was just about to say his name, too, but her son.
Don't put him out there like that.
No, but I was like, yo, my boy is in the other room, knowing he probably up on the phone with a girl all night. And then he heard that door close, and he heard so-and-so voice. Like,
okay, at the end of the day, then look, sis, you got to turn that TV up. If you ain't got no TV, then turn your phone on. Mm-hmm. And pretend like y'all watching Netflix or something and
get it in.
And put a movie up loud and just say, like, we about to go and watch a movie. Mm-hmm. Pop you some popcorn if you need some props. To make it seem like you're really about to watch a movie.
We just gonna go in here and watch TV.
Yeah. And then do what I do. Be quiet. Yeah. I mean, I have trained myself.
Yes. Yes.
I have two small kids. I am not gonna wake them up in the middle of my session because I'm being too loud.
Yeah, we have to be loud. And I think a lot of time, because he is older, so he is, like I said, like 15, 16, he's old enough to be at home.
So he knows not to bust in her door like
yeah.
that.
Yeah, and then he knows not to be, like, and then he can't be at home by himself. There probably have to be, like, times where she's going to probably have to do, like, hotel things, his place.
Yeah,
it'll just and the guy should understand. He should definitely understand. Like, I understand why you don't want to go to your place.
Yeah, but first things first, if this is somebody that you're dating seriously, mm-hmm. make sure that the son is comfortable with the guy. But if it's somebody you kind of just like with, like you're not really sure about,
just trying to get
and you're just trying to you might want to try to go to a hotel or that, because then you don't want your son to be like, ooh, my mom out here like
Because he is
doing her thing.
Then I had, you know, so. But yeah, if anybody happened to have that same issue and they have an answer, let us know. Because I'm very interested in it. Like, I want to know what y'all do. Because it's something that we personally cannot relate to.
But when your son turns 16, then what? I mean.
I'm with his daddy.
So?
How
long has she not been with this with her son's father?
I don't think he's ever been
so crazy. It's like,
you know what I mean? Like, I really think, because she has a good kid, and I think he's very understanding. Like, he knows. I mean, like I said, he's handsome. He gets the girls.
Yeah.
So he knows what goes down.
Yeah, and he probably, to be honest, he probably don't care as much as she. She does,
probably do, yeah.
Because I think it's different when you have a daughter. The girl is probably my mom is up there, like, whatever.
Yeah.
The guy's probably about it, but mm-hmm. he probably not harboring that. He probably ain't thinking about that. He probably like, man, trying to play
Fortnite.
Yeah, or 2K, whatever the games are. Like, the NBA, whatever. Mm-hmm. You're not thinking about that stuff.
Right, right.
I think she probably in her head too much, as women do.
But we do, and we are in our head a lot. Like, that could be a part of the issue. Like, she might be, like, overthinking things. Like we said in our first episode,
yeah,
we both overthink. And that could be it. Now, if he came to her, I have to get that. Like, I'm like, did he ever come to
now,
me?
Now, if he ever came to her and be like, Mama, so you be like, when y'all had it up close, y'all in there, like,
doing it?
That's a whole nother topic. Because then you got to make sure you have the conversation. Like, I'm grown.
And you stay in your business.
And you kind of, your women, your happiness is still your happiness, yes, at the end of the day.
She has to be happy.
If you feel like this man is somebody that is going, because your son is going to be leaving your house at some point. And then you're going to be there by yourself.
And you got to.
And I know you got to put your kids first and everything, but.
You have to put yourself
first. Make sure that your kids are, as long as they're in a safe environment, this guy ain't, you know, beating you up or beating your kid up or nothing like that.
Not with her.
Then, like, why not? Mm-hmm. Just be free. Live your life with no regrets.
No regrets. All right, because you heard it.
You heard it here first.
Mm-hmm. We're going to get some more info if we can, but if we're going to have to make this happen.
Because let us know what else is going on in your life.
Yes,
girl. We need to know.
Because she came at me with some stuff. That's why I love her.
Yeah, shout out to you, Tuzzo.
Mm-hmm. I mean, I'll say your name if you want me to in the next episode. Let's jump to one more thing. Or okay. However many. But I was thinking, like, emotional connection. So, my question is...
What's your question, Smith?
My question is, me personally, and I know for you it's probably the same thing, is for me to be intimate, I have to have an emotional connection. I know there's a lot of people out here who be like, you know, they be like, no strings attached. I mean, yeah. You my cup, buddy, point blank, period.
Yeah.
I've never been in that situation, and I don't think I could ever do that. But I want to know, like, these cup buddies, or do they even say that no more? They say,
I don't think so. You showing your age, sis.
Listen, y'all. Can we edit that out?
No.
Oh, okay.
I refuse. This is what happened when you hit your 30s. I refuse.
What they call a side piece now.
Side piece.
Well, no, because if they don't have a main, you can't be a side piece because you ain't side nothing. So, anyway, I don't know. We just think it too deep into it. But when you don't have no type of emotional connection, or so you say, or you just have that type of friend out there, like...
Is it possible that you really... Are you saying, is it really no strings attached?
Yeah.
I feel like you can get your feelings hurt. Somebody gonna get their feelings hurt.
I think eventually somebody will get their feelings hurt.
Because, okay... In order for me to be intimate with you, I have to be first attracted to you.
100%. That's just me.
That's just, I mean, there's nothing that's going to happen down there that's going to help you out in the situation.
No.
I have to be physically attracted to you.
Mm-hmm. Whatever your definition of being physical attracted, be attracted to the same or opposite sex?
Yes, I would have to be physically attracted to you. Before that could even happen, number one. Number two, if it does happen often enough, like, okay, so say for instance, I'm with a guy, mm-hmm. and we're having sex often, and it's just sex, and y'all, we don't plan on being boyfriend, girlfriend, but he go out and decide he want to have another friend that he having sex with too, I'm going to feel away. And I don't know why another woman wouldn't feel away either. Because I would be like, first of all, I don't need you dipping and dabbing in a lot of different other people.
Yeah.
What you going to bring back home to me?
That's what I'm scared. That's my thing. I mean, besides the fact of an emotional connection, which is the number one top thing. But, dude, it's diseases out in these
streets. And in Atlanta, is the worst.
Yeah. I cannot, like, I'm going to tell you, I'm scared of it. That's been my problem since I was younger. Man, the health class scared me.
That's what kept me from having sex.
Yeah, health class scared me.
I just didn't want to die. I felt like I was going to die.
It was going to fall off.
Yeah, all of it.
Yep.
What, your vagina?
Yep, just
shrivel up?
Yeah, shrivel up and fall. That's how I looked in them pictures. Because they got raw with us. And they started, as soon as we hit high school, they got raw. I was like, oh. Y'all ain't gonna ease into it in 10th grade?
I don't really even remember it.
To the core. What is the miracle of birth? I remember everything.
I don't remember it, but I do remember my mom drilling into me. I was scared of diseases and I was scared of having a baby. I was scared of both of those. My mom.
Your mom's funny.
She got pregnant with me at 16 and had me at 17. But was she even 17 yet? No, actually. She wasn't 17. She was 16 because my birthday comes before hers.
Yep.
So that was like my health thing. Like, I'm like, I did not want to have sex because I didn't want to have a baby. I couldn't take care of no baby.
Because not like she acts like an old woman at all, but she's like, she really taught y'all from her experiences. A lot of these young mothers don't do that.
My mom is a very, okay, how can I say? She is not, you know, she's not your typical young mom. Like, my mom is still in her 40s. She's 48, 49?
No, she's young.
She's still in her 40s. She hasn't turned 50 yet. But, yeah, I don't know if I would say she has an old soul, but she definitely wasn't out here, like, being my friend. Mm-hmm. We were not friends. She was my mother, and that was a parent.
Mm-hmm.
Like, at 16, 17 years old, she figured it out, and she's been me and my sister's mom since then. Like,
but I think of her now as, like you said, how she wasn't your friend then. I think of her now, like, you know how we called her the other day and asked her those questions about child number two.
Yeah.
She talked to us like a big sister. Yeah. Like, she wasn't like, why y'all want, like, she wasn't.
No, she talked
to us like almost like an older friend or a big sister.
Yeah.
And I like the way she. Not like my mom though, but my mom's a whole 60 something in these streets. But my mom's very, very understanding. You would never think she's 60 something. You would.
No,
she's not walking around with
love
cane.
Your mom.
She
love
literally has more energy than me.
Yeah.
I'm like, why does she have so much energy?
I don't know.
We can't do this. But no. Your mom's like.
She taught us a lot. And one of my favorite little stories to tell people is when me and my sister kind of, started to grow up a little bit more, and we were interested in the opposite sex heavy. First of all, my mom and my sister were both kind of, afraid for me for a little while. My mom came to me one day, and she was like, do you like boys? And I was like, yes, I like boys. I just don't want y'all in my business, so I don't talk about boys. Like, I was a very secretive child. Like, I just kept stuff to myself. If I like somebody, I might tell my sister or whatever, but I'm not finna be out here, on the phone. Like, if I am on the phone, then I'm on the phone without y'all being around.
Mm-hmm, in the room, quiet.
Yeah. My sister, hello. Hey, yeah, I'm over here. My mom over here, too. You want to talk to her? Like, my sister was big and bold with hers, and I wasn't. So, it was at some point where we were all still, it's always been me, my mom, my sister living in the house together. And so at some point, we just sitting down, and I forget how old we were, but I feel like I was in high school, and my sister was either coming to high school or leaving middle school. But I think it was high school, because I had a car then. Mm-hmm. Besides the point, she was like, we were all sitting there, she was like, Mama, I think I want to have sex.
Oh, you didn't tell me that.
My heart dropped because I just knew that the next question was going to be, Janae.
Oh, goodness.
Do you want to have sex too? And I'm like, oh, why are you staying? She was like, I don't know what it is, but I'm having these feelings and stuff. And I feel like I want to have sex. And then my mama was like, okay.
I wish I was there.
Let's talk about it. And then long story short, how I end up on birth control. And I wasn't even having sex. I was like, she was like, are you feeling these things too? I mean, I'm like, yeah, I guess, but I ain't out here doing nothing.
No, so calm down.
Yes. But my behind was on birth control. And she was like, well, it'll help regulate your cycle, because I don't have regular cycles. I still don't as of today. Mm-hmm. So she was like, it'll help regulate your cycle too, blah, 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 blah. And I'm like, okay, but I'll never forget that. My sister was so, she's always been so blunt and just straight to the point. Whereas I'm like, you ain't even going to know who I like until I tell you.
Yeah, that's how I was. I kept everything a secret. It was, so my best friend, and that was it. My brother asked me if I like girls. I mean, nothing against.
I'm like, I like them, but I don't like them like that.
Yeah, no, I was just like, no, I like boys. I'm just secretive. Like, I keep my business shy. Yeah. But I was very secretive when it came to my family and telling about my fun stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Outside
now it's quite normal, but yeah, then I definitely was quiet. I mean, like I said, guys, nothing against people who like, you know, the same sex. It's just not us.
Just not your cup of tea.
Not me.
And that's okay.
They thought it was, but not.
They thought it was. Yeah. They made me second guess myself. I'm like, hold on, do I? Let me think about this. I don't know. Maybe I don't know. But yeah, so that's all I really have about intimacy today.
Yeah, today. Yeah.
What do you have, sis?
I don't have nothing else. That's it right now. Like I said, and I'm going to keep saying it every time, just hit us up with questions.
And I want to say to my young brothers and sisters out here, especially my brother, and if you're listening, brother, yes, make sure that you're protecting yourself out here. You're young, handsome. Mm-hmm. You know, you got a lot going for yourself.
Yes.
You know, you just graduated Kennesaw State.
Hey.
Be out here making good decisions, you know what I'm saying?
I know. I mean, I would tell my brother the same thing, but I'm actually the youngest. He's the older one.
I could tell my sister the same thing, but she's young. I don't think she out here like that.
Oh, you're talking about your little sister. Yeah, I was like, she got a whole...
Unless she got a whole husband. Not that one.
Yes, yeah. My brother, he gonna do him anyway.
Yeah. Pretty much. You can't tell these people now. Everybody's going to do what they want to do anyway, but whatever.
Pretty much.
All right, y'all. Thank y'all so much again for listening to us today on Whines After Whines. Be sure to check out our social media page. That is Whines After Whines. And it's spelled, of course, WhineAfterWhines. And hit us up. We want to talk to y'all. We love to talk to y'all.
Definitely. All right. Thank you.
Enjoy your day, guys.
All right, bye.
Bye.